My name is Janelle Knox-Hayes. I'm a professor of urban studies and planning at MIT. At MIT, I head the Environmental Policy and Planning Group, and I work on a range of different research topics from climate mitigation and adaptation to energy transition. And woven throughout that work is a focus on community engagement and thinking about how to bring communities into technology development, into energy transition, and into better planning and decision-making. Community-based organizations are organizations that work locally with communities to improve different aspects of their health and well-being. And it's very important to study community-based organizations, or CBOs, with respect to solar, because they are essential in delivering goods and services to communities, especially low to moderate income communities, and they tend to deliver goods and services that government agencies find very difficult to deliver because they don't have the same level of trust and relationship and access to these communities. The study is different in that it's based on an in-depth analysis of community-based organizations that's built from a national survey of these organizations. So it's the data for the study were provided directly by the CBOs, and a range of different topics are included in the study, everything from how the organizations are structured, the nature of their work, the challenges they face, the strategies and opportunities that they have, and even how they work with other organizations and with state energy agencies. There are very interesting regional differences that we uncovered in this research. In the Southeast, there's a really big focus on solar justice and energy sovereignty and improving energy burden. In the Northeast, there's also a focus on solar installation. In the Midwest and Appalachia region, there's a focus on workforce training and development. So across the study, these differences are quite interesting to look at with regions. For the state energy agencies, this work is critically important because it helps them to understand, first, that there are differences across the organizations that they're working with, that there are differences within the region that they're working within, and that they can develop strategies specific to that region to make the work of CBOs more effective, and also to boost the specific needs of the, or to respond to the specific needs of the CBOs within their region. We found in the work that most of the funding sources for these communities are not state or federal grants. They are either relying on foundation grants, on individual donations to build their work within the CBO. And this is especially true when we look at work that's directed at solar installation. And so it suggests for state and federal governments that a critical pathway to deploying resources and having those resources implemented in development is missing. And the CBOs can play a critical role in building that mechanism or building that bridge of how to better deploy resources.